very next video. It's only been a little bit. I look over and I look at the guy laying on the ground, and I see the security guard at QT, because that they have to have security guards, you know, armed, gun on hip. And they started that when back in the day. Probably not because of me, but I used to steal a lot of food out of there, because they're not supposed to like physically stop you. So if you have an armful of burritos and like stacked all the way up my arm, you know, as far as I can get, I had like $40 in burritos. I don't know why I took a bunch of burritos. You know, it's not like I could have eaten them all. And I warmed them all up too. And a drink, and probably a hot dog and a pretzel, with all kinds of stuff. But I walked in and the manager saw me. I heard somebody calling me. Sir, sir, you think I'm gonna stop? You know, the cop just drove around it. This area is a rough area, you know, people panhandle all around here at every stoplight, you know, especially coming off the 17. And I panhandled there. I didn't like to do it though. It was, made me feel weird. I mean, who likes to stand there with a sign begging for money? I try to make the signs funny, you know, get people to laugh and throw money at you. For Christmas one year, we had this guy, Brandon. Oh, that's his name. I was trying to think of it last night. Brandon was using with us. He was living in the car with us too. He was sleeping in the back seat, sitting up, just like us. Oh, man. And we go do our business and pick up and, you know, stay well together. You know, it was like a team effort. You know, everybody had their part to play. Fucking baby driver that shit. Anyway, one Christmas, we went to Scottsdale to this spot. He's like, dude, I get big money every time I go when it's right down the street from my connect. It has fire. I was like, all right, let's go. Bet. Stood out there the whole day, $400 day. We got like the first 100 and we went and picked up. You know, it had been many hours since. And, people are looking at me again. Look, whatever. So, $400, we went and picked up, went back out there. People are just giving him 20s. And he had this like Bass Pro shirt. He, I guess he thought it made him look homeless. Because it was Bass Pro. I don't know. Fucking Brandon. Man, after I got out of prison, I hit somebody up that were mutual friends of his, and he ended up ODing. A few friends, several friends I lost. I can say proudly that in my car, many people did too much. Well, maybe not did too much, but the quality was good. So they would think, oh, it's nothing. But anyways, I never lost anybody on my watch. I've done mouth-to-mouth resuscitation and heart, you know, chest compressions and all that. And got them breathing again when their lips were blue and their eyes were rolled back in their head. That's an image. Never once did I lose anybody in my car in my presence, and I was around it a lot, you know? I was that guy that hit everybody. That's another story. Man, this is graphic and probably unsuitable for the minors in the group. In the world, it's not safe for work, whatever they say. Fuck heroin. Fuck heroin. Fuck heroin. Touch my face a lot. That's weird. It's 4:20. But yeah. If it wasn't me for weed, I wouldn't, like, I would have succumbed to my depression long ago. You know, the fact that the suicide rate among veterans is so high. You know, I think because of the pandemic, it's raised 25 or something crazy. That I know that I, like, I'll probably never do it, but that doesn't stop the thoughts. Plain and simple. Knowing that you wouldn't kill yourself, but knowing that you don't really care if you really exist. I love you, Mama. You're the only reason I'm still alive. Especially after Matthew, but that's a whole nother story, indeed. Well, a whole nother story, just not yet. This spot is really like, as I sit here and the sun goes down, I've just watched the same view so many times. On the other side over here is Premier Inn, which is a low budget, you know, you can pay daily, weekly, probably monthly, I don't know. Live there a lot, you know. We hotel surfed a lot. And the Premier Inn, you know, it's cheap. There's another few stories there. You know, when you let your dealer slash partner borrow your car to go, you know, make a deal and doesn't come back for 7 hours and you're withdrawing because you're waiting on him to get back and then he doesn't show up and they show up to kick you out of the room and you have all your stuff with you because you let him drive your car. You know, milk crates full of stuff, boxes full of stuff, just, and your girl and two dogs. So there's a church on the other side of the Hooters, and they have these like raised flower boxes. Well, there's like a part where in the corner there's a raised flower box, and in the corner, well, I had this sheet that was like the color of I had the sheet that was the color of the bricks, and I propped the sheet up to make it look like the wall went all the way across, and we hid below that for hours, because it was like at midnight that night that he finally dropped the car off over here or somewhere on the other side of the highway, because he was scared, because I would have fucking killed him. He took our house. The things you do for just a little bit more. To not hurt. To not withdraw. You know, I can honestly say I only got high a few times that whole time. It was all chasing the fucking dragon. That's the reason why they call it that. Just trying to stay well. Honestly. This feels good. So then, you know, it wasn't by choice to live in my car, but now I live in my van because it makes me feel good. It makes me feel like I'm doing something for myself and not for others. Because I think I spent so long putting out for others and taking away from me, that now it's time that, like, I have to give to myself, or, and those thoughts of not existing come back into play. I don't know why. And I've lost so many people to it that I don't think that, I don't know why. I don't know. It's crazy. I always said I would never do it, but the thoughts are still there. It's, and of course it's progressed over the years, the different stages, but this last 5 or 6 been clean, but you know, I don't really drink anymore. The last couple nights I kind of got drunk. You know, just a couple shots, though. I'm lightweight, like you wouldn't believe. Had a couple glasses of wine with my mom. That's about it. smoke my pot now. Another story. Okay, so I've been to prison. I guess I'll tell that in a story, but I started smoking when I got to state prison. When I got to the yard. Midnight specials, the pouch tobacco. You gotta roll them yourself. Of course, I was a, you know, amazing blunt roller. So, you know, rolling a, you know, little tiny stick cigarette wasn't nothing. So, I you know, did it well. Smoke because you ain't got nothing else to do in prison. You know, you got your after meal smokes and you got your late night smokes when you're not supposed to be outside, but you know, someone's got a lighter, so you're smoking in the boys' room. That's all boys, so there's not a girls' room. Yeah, there was a dude with tits on the yard. He was a paisa, didn't speak a word of English, had like, you know, one of those paisa mustaches, but he had these big old triple double D's, whatever. The Latinos, Chicanos, whatever, they loved him. I'm sure he made plenty of ramen noodles and sodas. I'll stop there. Anyways, I feel like I'm trailing off on this one. Where was I going? I don't know. It's been 11:30. I'll make another one. This feels good. I should have done this a long time ago. Thanks for the suggestion. Can't do TikTok, it's too long for that. Maybe snippets? I don't know. But oh, I was showing you the van. It's, you know, I haven't even slept one night fully in here. Mainly because nobody will, like, believe me that this is what I want to do. Like, I find it comfortable. I don't know. Especially now that I got a full-size bed, you know. And then once I get everything really buttoned up and together, this rack will look better. You know, I'll have like everything able to be displayed and properly put up. And I gotta get window blocks made. So, but I haven't really slept in here. I got, you know, sheets to hang up if I have to. But anyway, 12 minutes and 28.